Ladies and gentlemen, the story you're about to see is one of passion, of betrayal, of violence, and of murder. We're going to take you back to America in the 1920s, the roaring 20s, where criminality ruled the streets. Please join us on our journey to Cook County in the city of Chicago.
Oh, what's the hurry? Amos ain't gonna be home until after midnight. You know, I think it's about time we met your friend down at the club. It's been about a month since you told him about me.
Hey, Roxy, look, it's getting late, okay?
Well, I've been thinking a lot about my career. You know, I think we should open up a club. I could be the headliner. And you could be the manager.
Get off! Oh,
what's the idea, Harv?
Wake up, kiddo. You ain't never gonna have an act. Face it, Roxy. You're a two-bit talent with skinny legs and a generous chest.
Oh, Harv, but you got connections, you know? That guy down at the club.
There's no guy. Sugar, your hot stuff. I would say anything to get a piece of that. Listen, we had some laughs. Let's just leave it at that, all right?
Oh, Harv, you're a liar.
Oh, yeah, well, that's life, sweetheart. What you gonna do about it, eh?
Oh, Harv.
Oh, Harv.
Yeah, what?
Nobody walks on me. You may be alive outside, but you are going to hell and back.
But, sweetheart!
Don't sweetheart me. You son of a bitch.
Telling the truth, it's the truth. My wife would have nothing to it. She wouldn't even hurt a worm, not a worm. When I fired the first shot, she somehow opened her eyes. But then she was asleep. When I think what would have happened if I'd gone in for a beer instead of just come straight home, it makes me sick to even think about it.
So you're telling me you shot Harvey Norman?
Harvey Norman? That's Harvey Norman? But my wife knows it. He sold his furniture. He gave a 69% discount.
Look, it's pretty clear to me. Your old lady shot him.
Oh no, he was trying to burgle me.
From what I hear, he's been burgling you 3 times a week for the last month.
Roxy, how can you do it, Roxy? Get her out of here.
Must be hard. Ain't you pretty? Oh,
thank you, ma'am. Ma'am.
Why don't you call me Mama? I'm here to take care of you. You'd be happy living down here in this block. Murderer's Row, we call us.
Is it nice? I somehow don't belong here. I didn't do anything wrong.
Let me guess. You didn't do it? You don't need to tell me, honey. I rarely heard of a man getting killed who didn't deserve us. When you come round to the deal, you come talk to me.
Hey, Mama, come here.
Velma? Velma Kelly? The Velma Kelly? Oh my God, I was there that night, that you got arrested.
Yeah, you went out to Chicago. Go away, Blondie.
Hey, Mama, come look at this. Another story about me in Image Magazine. The newspapers are calling me Crime of the Year. And it says here, not a memory to be recalled. Oh, such a horrible double homicide.
Velma, honey, you can buy that comfortably.
Couldn't buy it. Guess I can keep these then.
Nice try. You see, you take care of Mama.
Yeah.
Mama will take care of you. I'll talk to that Billy Flynn, the lawyer. March 5th, he's set to arrive. March 6th, you'll get acquitted. March 7th, you know what Mom's gonna do for you?
What?
Mom's gonna put you back up in the gaiety service.
I've been in a lot of gaiety shows. How much dough are we talking about?
Well, with your recent sensational activity, I can talk to the boys. You're talking about $2,500.
$2,500? Jeez! The most me and Veronica made was $1,500.
Yeah, that was before.
You know what, Mama? I always wanted to play the Sugar Club. Can you get me that?
The Sugar Club? That's a different story. That'll cost you a phone call.
How much is that phone call going to cost?
Velma, you're part of the family. I care about you. Do you have $50?
$50? Jeez, Mama, you should change to Vodafone.
Oh, Mama! It's a little bit chilly in here. Do you think the heat might be broken? Can I get a few blankets? Not that I'm complaining or anything.
Blankets, huh? You think you're the new star of the jail? Listen here, you stay out of my way in here. You're a petty murderer like the rest of us.
I'm not guilty.
Yeah, right.
Tell it to the judge.
Now, Roxy, I'm sure you had it coming. Ain't that right, ladies?
Hey,
And now, the six merry murderesses of Cook County Jail in their rendition of the Cell Block Tango.
Shit.
Swiss roll.
Lip shits. Pop.
Six.
Squish.
Swiss roll.
Pop.
Six.
Squish.
Swiss roll.
Lip shits.
He had it coming. He had it coming. He only had himself to blame. If you'd have been there, if you'd have seen it, I bet you would have done the same.
I come home this day and I'm feeling really irritated. And I'm looking for a little sympathy. Bernie's lying on the couch, having a beer, chewing his gum. No, not chewing, popping. I say, Bernie, you pop that gum one more time. And he did. So I took the shotgun off the wall and I fired two warning shots into his head.
He had it coming, he had it coming. He only had himself to blame. If you'd have been there, if you'd have seen it, I bet you would have done the same.
I met Ezekiel Young from Salt Lake City about 2 years ago, and he told me he was single. We hit it off right away and moved in together. Every day he'd go to work, he'd come home, I'd make him a cocktail, we'd have dinner, until I found out. Single, he said. Single, my ass. Not only was he married, he had six wives. One of those Mormons, you know. So, when he came home that evening, I fixed him his usual cocktail. Some guys cannot hold their arsenic.
He had it coming. He had it coming. He got the flower in his prime. And then he used it. And he abused it. It was a murder, but not a crime.
I'm standing in the kitchen, charving up the chicken for Carl's dinner. And in he storms in a jealous rage. He says, you've been screwing the milkman. And he was crazy. He kept on screaming, you've been screwing the milkman. And then he ran into my knife. He ran into my knife 10 times.
If you'd have been there, if you'd have seen it, I bet you would have done the same.
heksen zeggen dat ik mijn man heb vermoord. Met een botte bijl. Maar ik heb het niet gedaan. Ze zeggen van wel. Maar ik was het niet. Ik heb het geprobeerd uit te leggen aan de Cardi. Maar die spraken geen Nederlands.
But did you do it?
Not guilty.
My sister Veronica and I had this double act. And my husband Charlie traveled around with us. Now for the last number in our act with these 20 acrobatic tricks in a row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Split, spread eagle, backflip, flip-flop. One right after the other. So this one night before the show, we're down at the Hotel Swiss Roll. The three of us boozing, having a few laughs. And we run out of ice. So I go out to get some. I come back, open the door, and there's Veronica and Charlie doing number 17. The spread eagle! Well, I was in such a state of shock, I completely blacked out. I can't remember a thing. It wasn't until later, when I was washing the blood off my hands, I even knew they were dead. They had it coming. They had it coming. They had it coming. How could you tell me that I was wrong? They had it coming.
Had it coming.
They had it coming.
They had it coming.
They had it coming all along. I didn't do it.
I didn't do it.
But if I'd done it,
how, she done?
How could you tell me that I was wrong?
I love Calvin Lipschitz more than I could possibly say. He was a real artistic guy. Sensitive, a painter, but he was always trying to find himself, and every night he'd go out looking for himself, and on the way he met Ruth, Gladys, Rosemary, and Irving. I guess you could say we broke up because of artistic differences. He saw himself as alive, and I saw him as dead.
Dirty bum, 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 bum. Dirty bum, bum, bum.
They had it coming,
they had it coming all along.
And they abused us, and they abused us. How could you tell me that I was wrong? He had it coming,
he had it coming,
he had it coming,
he had it coming,
he had it coming.
So too late.
If you have been there,
if you have seen it,
I bet you you would have done the same.
Artistic differences.
17, the spread eagle.
Squish.
Swiss roll.
Lipschitz.
I bet you you would have done the same.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Chicago. Come on, Chicago! Come on! Well done, Chicago. Well, wasn't the wait worth it? Wasn't that wait worth it? It's always the first thing to start the show and the most nervous, so the wait was worth it. So I'm going to go straight to our judges. Francis? Can we hear your comments on this wonderful music, Chicago?
Well, wow. My God, I don't want to come up against those ladies ever if I do something wrong to any of them. They're positively scary. I loved, loved, loved every single bit of it. And fair play, the first to come on stage in the night is always the most
absolutely,
difficult.
Absolutely.
I felt for them. Particularly when we were setting up you were setting up the stage, and they were all waiting patiently to get back on the stage. So, getting down to business. Oh God, Blondie, I'll just give you my number afterwards. Singing was fabulous, and your use of the stage was really, really, really good.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Frances. Mika, I was very impressed with your performance, and I don't have an understudy yet for the Gaiety. Would you be free?
I would be, actually.
Oh, jeez. Let's go to our next judge, Mr. Philip Boucher-Hayes. Philip.
There have been 7,500 performances of Chicago since it was first staged. If it took as long to start, if all of them took as long to start as yours did, there would only have been 7,500. But after that, it was brilliant. It was brilliant in every respect, except here's what I am deducting marks for. I had to look at David Miller's chest. That's one mark. And I had to look at a husband and wife team perform pages 200 to 250 of the Kama Sutra, Lorna and Dan. So that's another mark.
Ladies and gentlemen, Philip Boucher-Hayes. And finally, Mr. Keith Manning. Keith?
Well, I'm in Philip's camp. Looking at David Miller with the chest, he definitely needs some man grooming. There's a lot of work to be done. I think overall, absolutely amazing performance. Lots of hard work. I'd say lots of fun during the week practicing. Lots of rooms in the hotel were being used to get the acts right. Very good. Well done.
Thank you very much, Mr. Keith Manning. So finally, thank you very much, Lorna, Dan, Jane, David, Emma, Michelle, Stephen, Louise, Sinead, Graham and Mika. Ladies and gentlemen, let's have your votes out from our judges. So for Mr. Philip Boucher-Hayes, your vote, please, and your number is 8 for Philip Boucher-Hayes. From Francis. Francis gives us an 8 from Francis. And finally, Mr. Keith Manning gives us a 10. Thank you very much, and off you go, ladies and gentlemen. The first 10 of the evening.